This is FDchick again, and today I'm bringing you another game of my favorite type of game to play in Call of Duty, Search and Destroy. I also will be answering a couple questions that I received after I asked for them in my last video. I actually got some really, really funny questions, and then some pretty valid questions to answer, so I will go ahead and address those. I wanted to show you this video because I think I did pretty well in here, and I got some pretty good kill cams as well as the last kill cam, which I think probably is the best one, just because I was kind of like, oh, he's right there, and turned around and got him. So let's see, one of the first questions that I received was how do you get to talk to girls, and like, how do you get a girl to talk to you, I guess? And my answer to that is, you know, find something that you have in common with them. I think that's one of the most easiest way to start a conversation with somebody is if you know something that they like, or if you know that they like something that you do, then you can talk about that, you know, movies, whatever it is that you have in common with them. That's a great leeway to start off with. It's so easy to talk about something that you know about and that you know that they like, or, you know, if you know that this person's interested in something and you happen to be really good at that, that's probably the best way. Cars or movies, pretty much anything that you guys have in common is a great conversation starter. Dogs or whatever, you know. You just never know what girls are into. I'm just, like, for me, you know, I can't really speak for every other girl out there, but for me, I love dogs. So if I'm walking down the street and some guy has a really cute dog, you know, it's more easier for me to just be like, hey, you know, I love your dog, and like, what kind of dog is it, and blah blah blah, and you start a conversation like that. And it works all the way around too, you know. Girls will ask you and you will ask them about stuff, and then it's just, you know, really easy to talk about something that you both like. I'm going to link a video right here to this video by another YouTuber called SkyyJohn. And he's just like this amazingly funny guy. He's pretty blunt and he tells it how he sees it. So for those of you out there that get really offended by what people say, I probably wouldn't recommend you watching this video. But I love this video because he pretty much talks about how to talk to a hot chick. And for you guys out there, this is a must-see video. He pretty much says, you know, if you talk to a hot chick like you would to any other chick, you know, any fat girl, any ugly girl out there, then you won't have any issues. And I totally agree with that. You know, you just talk to everybody like you would talk to anybody else. And you won't get nervous, or you won't get, you know, you won't say something stupid if you just act like, hey, this person's like any other person out there. You know, they may look better, but they're still a person. And so I'm going to link the video, and you guys should definitely watch it. I think that you guys will be a little bit surprised about some of the things he says in his other videos. But check his channel out too. I totally support him. He's a really funny guy on top of that, and he always has these hot chicks on his videos. So another question that I was asked was, what do girls look for in a guy? And like I said again, I don't know, you know, the question to every other girl out there, but for me, I always feel like I'm always looking for a guy who can provide some stability for me. For example, you know, if he's always moving from girl to girl, or from job to job, or house to house, and it kind of feels like, hey, is this guy really going to stick with me? So if you show that you can actually hold down something, a family, a job, or you know, a relationship, it just makes the other girl feel so much better. And let's say, for example, if you're talking to a girl and she asks you, you know, how long was your last relationship, and you happen to say, well, you know, 2-3 months or something, then of course the girl's gonna think like, hey, this guy's not gonna last very long, and he's really not gonna stick long enough for me to even get to know him. So it makes us girls feel a little less welcoming, and probably won't, you know, much of a thought afterwards. So try to you know, show that you're stable. And also, I'm always looking for someone to make me feel like I'm a girl. So, for example, you know, I'm like this 5'2" tall girl, and I always like taller guys. I always feel like they can make me feel like I'm the girl and they're the man, and, you know, they can kick somebody's ass if somebody's talking shit about me, that kind of thing. Not that they would, not that I expect them to or anything, but, you know, just the fact that they make me feel like a girl makes me feel so much better. You know, feeling loved, everybody wants to feel loved, of course. Nobody ever wants to be treated like shit. Whatever your definition of feeling loved is, that's what you want to get. That's what girls are looking for, you know, just to feel like they're loved. And if you show them that you appreciate them and that you can provide for them or love them, then a girl will always try to, you know, do a little bit more for you. And that's pretty much, hopefully that answers your question. I'm not quite sure exactly if that does or not, but, you know, hopefully it does. Another question, this one's actually a kind of funny one, but one of my friends asked me, Sifu, he asked me, how wood can a woodchuck chuck? And I don't really know how to answer that, but I do know that if Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers, where is a peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked? And that's the only tongue twister I know out there. So, Sifu, you're going to have to answer that one for yourself. I don't know. I also got many, many questions regarding Black Ops. You know, am I going to get it? Did I get it? Do I like it? What do I think about it? And my answer to you guys is this. I did pre-order it. I actually got it on the day it was released at my house, and I did not open it because I heard all the bad reviews, and I just didn't want to open it in case I wanted to return it and get my full monies back. I actually ended up giving it away to my brother who found out I was gonna return it, and just, you know, he said he wanted it, so I gave it to him. So I might actually hop on Black Ops once in a while if I get it from him to play zombie mode or the wager matches. But honestly, I didn't really look forward to it, and after all the reviews, I didn't want to say like I told you so or anything, but I didn't really feel like I wanted to keep the game, so I just gave it away. But I might hop on, like I said, to play sometime down the road. Who knows. A couple of people asked me about doing a commentary, and I would love, honestly, to do a dual commentary with you guys. Just send me your videos or upload it privately, and I will take a look at it, and, you know, we can go ahead and work something out. I'm not quite sure exactly how it's gonna work, probably by Skype or MSN, something like that. But I would love to do that, so just let me know. And ChrisSmoove, if you are watching this or listening to this, I am telling you that I would love to do a dual commentary with you. So I'm kind of calling you out, but I think you're really funny, and you have some good insights on the game, and yeah, just, it would be fun. So let me know if you are listening to this. I think this is pretty much the game. I just wanted to show you a little bit about you know, this gameplay, and this last guy that we're going to be looking for, it was kind of camping a little bit, so I think that you will enjoy the last kill cam. And if you have any other questions, like I always say, feel free to ask me, message me. I do try to get back to you guys as soon as possible. And it's always fun, of course, to talk to you guys and hear your thoughts and all that. So let me know. I probably will be holding some kind of like contest in the future pretty soon. I'm not quite sure yet, but more info on that later. And then, yeah, definitely subscribe. And I will leave you with one little thing. I don't know how to drop shot, so somebody's gonna have to teach me. So teach me how to drop shot. Teach me how to drop shot. I don't know. that would be fun. Also quick scoping, that kind of thing. So let me know if you would like to do that. And see you guys on the game sometime. All right, have a good one.
Tirando uma granada de luz.